In this video, I'll share with you a Chrome extension that can help you analyze and improve the structure of your web pages. But before I jump in, if you are a photographer and you want to know more about SEO, you want more quick, easy tips, make sure to subscribe to the channel for more videos just like this one. All right, so as you can see on the screen, I'm looking here in the Chrome Web Store at an extension called headingsMap. You can just do a Google search for headingsMap Chrome extension and you should be able to find this page. When you do, all you need to do, this right now says remove from Chrome because I've already got it installed, but it should say add to Chrome or something similar to that if you land on this page and you don't have the extension yet. Once you add the extension, it's going to look like this. It's a little H slash inside of the carrots here. That's the icon for this extension. Okay, so I'm going to show you what this extension does. You can also look here and see some of the features that are available. But it's essentially what happens is whenever, I'll turn it off so we can turn it on. Whenever you're on any web page, you're able to click this headings map extension and it will show you the headings of the page in outline form. So it's going to show you the order in which they appear on the page or in the code. You can see 1, 2, 3, these are H1, H2, and H3 tags. Now, it will go down to 4, 5, and 6 as well. If those appear, you can see on this page, they do not. At the top, it should show the title of the page. And then the H1 should be, in most cases, here at the beginning. And then you'll have these other headings nested the way that they appear on the page. Now, this is one example of a page that's nested fairly well, although it gets kind of flat around the H3 section. I think that there are probably some things here that are H3s that should probably be H4s nested underneath some of the other H3 topics. The whole idea with headings is that they should indicate the structure of a web page. They should show topics and their organization, their relationship to each other. And this is a great way to get a visual on those headings and how they appear on your page. Let's look at a couple of other examples because I'm going to show you some of the other things this tool can show you. Here is an example where you see these H2s that are red and they don't have any text. That's because they're blank H2s that are found on the page. You can click on them and it will show you there's an H2 here in the code. It's just there's nothing in it. It's just an open H2 and a closed H2. So this is another cool thing is that it can show you empty heading tags. These don't necessarily hurt anything, but they're one of those things that you can clean up if you're trying to get your page to be, you know, optimized to be perfect. So that's one thing I can do. I can help you find those broken tags. Here's an example of one that I ran where I was actually surprised by what I found. Now on Show It in particular, headings are typically a mess. It doesn't surprise me, but I had worked on this page before and I guess I didn't go back and look at this headings map to see how screwed up it was in the code. And this one actually is ranking pretty well, much better than the one before it, after I had cleaned up some other issues with headings and structure of the page. But still, there's a lot of improvement to be done here. First of all, the navigation, the main navigation, are H3 tags, and they don't need to be. They should be nav items, or they could even just be regular divs. They don't need to be headings. A lot of people use headings for styling when they should be using them for structure. Now, you can use them for styling as well, but they should be first and foremost used for structure on the page. And then notice here, the H1 on this page happens to be want to feel like this on your wedding day. Now, I'm curious to see, I'm going to use Open SEO Stats, another Chrome extension. I may do another video on this and see. Okay, browse by venue. Want to feel like it's in your way. So it's showing there's 3 H1s here, but it's correct that it's not the best wedding venues in Columbus. Let's zoom in on that. I'm going to use it to right click and click inspect. And you can see here, this is actually just a P paragraph tag, not an H1. So that should be the H1, the best wedding venues in Columbus, Ohio. And it's not. And so, and then after that, the correct structure for this would be that each of these venue names would be an H2. It could be an H3, and you could have H2s above that that would say outdoor wedding venues in Columbus, and then you have an H3 with the name of the outdoor venue And then you could have historic wedding venues in Columbus as an H2, and then the H3 would be the names of the venues. And then you could have it even broken down further. So there's an H4 on the venue that says ceremony details, reception details, whatever else. Those could be H4s if you wanted to go that deep. You can go all the way down to H6, but they should be organizing content. And as you can see here, there's issues with the sidebar having headings in it that it shouldn't. Now, it's not necessarily a problem to have headings in a sidebar, but by the way this page is structured, it kind of throws off the entire structure of the page. Finally, we'll look at one that's a pretty good example of organization. I actually had a harder time than I thought, even on my own sites, coming up with one that was a perfect example of heading organization. This is a fairly recent plugin that I found, and even making this video has helped me realize I need to use it far more often. But you can see here the title of the page and then the H1, which is totally fine for those to be the same, by the way. The destination wedding photographer dilemma is the H1. And then we have these H2s, destination wedding photographer, adventure elopement photographer, what we recommend, a few examples, and then the examples themselves, Cabo wedding photographer, Yosemite elopement. Those are all, that's the correct structure for this page. You can even see that we used a table of contents plugin here that creates a table of contents based on the heading structure. So when you use this plugin, you're kind of forced to create the correct kind of map for this page, the right kind of outline. Now, what I did notice is that after what we learned, which is the last topic of the page, it jumps over here into the sidebar and grabs these H5s, and then it has this H2. This post has two comments and an H3 for each name, and then leave a reply. So if I wanted to really optimize this theme, I believe I would probably come in here and change those to not be headings and just to use some other div style or div class. But that's kind of getting nitpicky, at least in this case. These are not really a huge deal. I don't like that these are seen as H5s of what we learned, because that could say, here, if Google is trying to determine like what's the summary of this page, and they see what we learned and they consider that the summary, they may think the summary of this page is recent posts and categories and then whatever falls under those. And that's not the case at all here. So we want to make sure that we're giving Google a very clear outline, that we're giving users a skimmable outline of our page with our headings. So hopefully this plugin will help you to discover what the heading structure of your pages looks like. What questions do you have about headings, how they should be used, and the plugin itself? I would love to hear that in the comments here on the video or over in the Facebook group. Just go to Facebook and search for Fuel Your Photos. Also, check the description of the video. I'll add one or two links to a few more resources about headings, as well as the link to the plugin itself. If you found this video useful, I'd love for you to leave a thumbs up. It helps me to know that I should keep making this kind of content. And if you have other questions, just leave them in the comments below, and I'll see you next time.